Hey everybody, welcome back. Today I'm going to be talking about the miracle drug that is Benlysta. A lot of people who have lupus, I think it's just lupus that they give Benlysta to, but if it's something else and you're like Googling Benlysta because they gave it to you for fibromyalgia, or, I don't know, psoriatic arthritis, I really don't know if they give it for anything else. I really should have researched that before I started this video, but I didn't, so here we are. It has helped me more than any other drug I've ever used. It's not like prednisone where it kicks in almost immediately. It usually doesn't kick in fully until 6 to 9 months after starting usage. There are two ways Benlysta can be put into the body. Number one is infusions. The other one is injection. I have only ever done the injections and they have worked absolutely amazing for me. Like all biologics, Benlysta comes with a pretty extensive list of risk factors and side effects. Things that are on that list include increased depression, anxiety, suicidal ideation, migraines, skin cancer, upset stomach, the list goes on, different kinds of cancer. It's not great. It's basically one of those commercials where everybody is like all happy and they're just like talking about all the ways that it can kill you. That is a biologic. That is what Benlysta is. So it was definitely something that I had to weigh when I started it. One thing about Benlysta though is when I first started it, it was $3,000 for 1 month supply, and now it is $4,500 for 1 month supply. So it is a very, very expensive drug and they do not prescribe it to just anyone. Most of the time, in order to have it prescribed to you, you have to meet certain criteria, meaning you tried a certain list of medications. I know Plaquenil is on there and azathioprine is on there. Either you took them and they didn't work, or you were unable to take them for one reason or another. But you have to have that list of medications already tried and failed in order to get prescribed Benlysta. So I know you're thinking, how the hell does anybody actually afford Benlysta? Because that is more than most people make in a month. How could anyone afford such an expensive drug? There's this program called the Benlysta Gateway Program. And basically what they do is they put $15,000 into an account for you. It's similar to an HSA, but instead of only being able to be used on health related stuff, it's strictly Benlysta. That is the only thing it can be used for. So there's kind of a great loophole in the system where if you have insurance, they will say, I'm sorry, we're not going to pay for that until your deductible is met, and then we will pay for it. People's insurances, their deductibles are under $10,000. And so you can get a few months of Benlysta and then you actually reach your deductible out of pocket. Every single time the insurance bounces it back and says, we're not going to pay for it, it comes out of the Benlysta Gateway Program. So I've actually been doing this for going on 3 years now, and I usually meet my deductible within the first few months, and then all of my medical expenses as well as medications are completely free for the remaining months of the year, and then my Benlysta is also taken care of. So I have actually never paid a dime for my Benlysta. Typically when a doctor prescribes it to you, they will tell you about the Benlysta Gateway Program and make sure you get signed up for it. My doctor wouldn't even let me leave the office until I was signed up for it, which is very helpful because she knew how expensive it was and I did not until I got my first shipment. There are two ways you can receive Benlysta if you get the injections. If you get an infusion, you either have to go to your doctor's office or some kind of infusion center for them to give it to you. I have not had that done, so I would recommend looking at other videos. Maybe just type in Benlysta infusions and you can have some girls talking about what that's like. The injections, however, those can either be sent to your house. Sometimes you have to get a doctor's approval for that to happen, or they can send it to your local pharmacy. You can get it there. They who are sending it is actually a specialty pharmacy. Normal pharmacies don't actually have them. So my pharmacy is out of Michigan that sends it to me, and I just have it delivered straight to my door. Now for the reason why you're all watching this video, how long does it take to work and what side effects did I experience from it? So I will say that it took me about 2 months to start feeling a difference. The doctors all said it was gonna be 6 months to a year before anything kicked in. And around the 2 month mark, I was feeling so much better. Where I was at my health at the time was I was really, really good in the morning till about 10 o'clock. And then my energy would just drastically start declining. By noon, I needed to have everything done for the day that was my goal. So anything I needed to do, laundry, prep, dinner, anything like that needed to be done by noon because I knew that the rest of the afternoon I was just gonna be laying down. By 4, I knew I couldn't walk anymore. And by 7, I needed to be in or close to bed because that was the end of my day. That was consistent every single day. After a few weeks of being on the Benlista, I noticed that I was still able to be walking around at 2 p.m., which was fantastic. After 8 weeks of being on the Benlista, I had actually stood to make dinner, which usually I'm in bed by then. And after my kid had gone down, I remember going back into the kitchen and being able to dance around with the cat, which I had not done in years. I was so excited about it and I felt so good. It did come with certain side effects. The first side effect it came with was after I would take it, the next day was a complete wash. I would be sleeping all day. I felt terrible. It was one of those where it was like, why am I even taking this? Because I felt so bad. I also knew that I had to take it right before bed because it would put me out almost immediately. Another side effect I experienced was whenever I did wake up, I would wake up into a panic attack. My anxiety was off the charts. It was really terrible. After I got over the side effect of sleeping so much, it actually had the opposite effect where I would wake up at 4 a.m. after going to bed at 10 the night before. Again, I would wake up into that panic attack of just crying, so much fear, shaking. It was like the anxiety was in my body, not really like, oh, I'm afraid of something in particular, but it just felt like the anxiety was inside me and it was really dark, it was really scary. A few hours later, it would always pass. I definitely alerted my pharmacist and my doctor to this because if you start having suicidal ideation or severe depression, anything like that, they do recommend you stop it. She was aware of it and she was willing to move me more towards once every 10 days instead of every 7 days, but she really wanted to see if I could just ride through the symptoms and see if they dissipated. They did. It was probably about 6 months after I started taking it that I had no side effects whatsoever. I am actually still like that. I have been on Benlista for almost exactly 3 years now, and it is my miracle drug. I absolutely love taking it. Now I actually get excited when it's the weekend and I get to take it again because I get this boost of energy for the first few days of the week, and I'm so thankful for this medication. I am actually going to take it in front of you guys today and show you how it works. So with Benlista, they actually recommend that you put it in the fattiest part of your body. So typically they recommend you putting it on the stomach or on the thigh. I'll come down here and tell you about this. I have actually noticed a drastic difference if I put it in my stomach than if I put it in my thigh. I actually noticed that about a year after I was taking it, where if I put it in my stomach, I would feel like I was flaring all week. However, if I put it in my thigh, I would feel really, really good. So I have not put it in my stomach for probably a year and a half now. That is something you can play around with. It does hurt less going into your stomach than it does into your thigh. I will tell you that much. It is a very, very thick liquid and it burns like hell going in. It's probably the worst pain I feel all week, except for today, because I got my rug pierced. Yeah, that hurt like hell. So today it won't be the worst pain I felt, but it'll be close. Like, it's not comfortable, it's terrible, but it is over quickly. So that's real. It comes in these great little packages. The people who prescribe it to you will send you bandages, alcohol pads, and a sharps container for you to put this in. As you can see here, there's clear liquid in there. You always want to hold it up to the light and see if there's any flecks in it. There are none in this. If there are bubbles, that is fine, but you just don't want to see like any flecks looking there's anything that's like shaved off or sloughed off in it. If there is, you need to call your pharmacist and they will request you send it back to them and then they'll send you a new batch. So don't worry, you're still gonna get your drug. So I have noticed the higher I put it, the less it hurts. As you can see here, I have all these old bruises from where I do my drug. You're gonna wanna prep the area with an alcohol pad. Also, always make sure you wash your hands prior to doing this. I usually let it dry a little bit. You just open it like that. And then with this, it's pretty tricky because it clicks when it first goes in, and then this pushes it all the way down, but then it clicks again and it still pushes more in. So after the second click, you really need to watch the plunger and make sure it goes all the way through before you pull it away from yourself. Go. And that's how you take the Benlysta shot. If you guys are on Benlysta, let me know how it does for you. Let me know if you couldn't get on it for any reason, or if you tried it and it just really didn't work for you. Also, word to the wise, if you are on Benlysta, you need to wear sunscreen every single day of your life. You also have to have yearly skin checks with a dermatologist. Very imperative because there is a high comorbidity with melanoma or skin cancer if you're on Benlysta. So just make sure you have those two safeguards in place. Actually, what I do is I put 100 SPF mixed in with my facial moisturizer and I just make sure it's always on me every single morning, and then I put some on the tops of my shoulders if I'm going to be wearing sleeveless throughout the day or anything like that. So that's my video on Benlysta, and I hope it helps you as much as it helped me. See ya.